Let's play FIFA 18 on PS4 Slim. It's 52.38 GB and I have updated to latest version so that we can play FIFA World Cup 2018. Let's play. Note, you can only be able to play the World Cup edition only after updating the game to the latest version.
EA Sports. To the game.
Always worth looking at these international matches.
Yeah, and it will be interesting seeing how the players react, because one or two new to the international scene, so nerves might play a part. You want to settle quickly for your country, it takes a bit of time. We'll see what's the difference here.
This match will feature Argentina against France. And this is a matchup between two international teams today. The disadvantage, Alan, is that they don't play together very often. Positive, of course, is they are the country's very best players.
They are indeed, and we have got some quality players to enjoy out there today, but as you say, no, all of them have played together too often, so there might be a slight lack of understanding at times.
the first World Cup, Alan, as a commentator, 1978 in Argentina, won by Argentina. And I'll never forget the outpourings of joy from the local fans at that triumph.
Yeah, the ticker tape, Mario Kempes, Aussie art dealers, great times for the country.
With this line, Federico Fazio plays alongside Nicolas Otamendi at the back. Lucas Piglia plays with Ava Benego in the engine room. Gonzalo Higuain is the sole striker today.
Well, interesting how France will line up today. Here it is.
Bugalari starts in goal. Rafael Varane starts with Samuel Umtiti as the centre-back. Antoine Griezmann plays up with Olivier Giroud. Attack is on here. Olivier Giroud, Mbappe. And there's a cutback. He must have thought he'd scored from that distance. The keeper had other ideas. France have been given the corner.
Second half to start now, and it's Argentina to do just that.
got on the ball in midfield. Well, really trying to use the full width of the pitch here to make some progress. Now it's Ousmane Dembele. Not a threat at the moment, but they have got the ball, and that, I suppose, is a threat.
Chance!
Scoring position then, but anything but. That's it. It's good play until they got that challenge in. What an opportunity if he picks out the right man. Now to play for a throw. An incisive pass. This could be dangerous for the opposition from Higuain. And that breakaway did look dangerous. This is well, they've won the ball back. Now it's Ousmane Dembele. Lent the ball to its mate and got it back again. Argentina's throw. Angel Di Maria.
He's got his shot off now.
Oh, no scraps for the attackers to feed up from the goalkeeper that time. Come onto the ball well. Little headed pass then, and a shrewd one. Some potential in this move.
Higuain, that's a decent stop.
But not perhaps going for the top 10.
No, but he was on his toes, wasn't he? He was ready for it.
It's going to be a change here for Argentina. Swung in from the corner. Brings the punch here, the goalkeeper. Good technique. They're keeping the ball patiently, probing. They need to penetrate the opposition if they're going to equalise. Still one goal needed to get level, and they've got a corner. To get your side into some sort of shape, and I think it's been very useful here. It will go down as a defeat, but it's not one that they'll lose any sleep over, surely.
No, I think so. It's all about getting ready for the competitive action, isn't it? And some lessons learned perhaps for the manager.